Hello everyone, myself Bhautik Trivedi, working as an assistant professor in IT ICT department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. I will explain you the concept of SMTP and FTP in Advanced Networking Protocol subject. So first of all of you know the concept of email. So for the email purpose, which particular protocol that's the part of the email? So that is SMTP. What is the full form of SMTP? Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. And second one, that is the FTP. FTP means that is generally used for the file transfer purpose. So that is known as a file transfer protocol. So in today's session, mainly focus on the two important protocol. One, that is the SMTP, and second one, that is the FTP. So let's start with the concept of SMTP first of all. So let's start with this. So what is the meaning of SMTP here? So one of the most popular network service is electronic mail. So electronic mail, that is also known as a email. So in TCP/IP protocol that support the email on an internet. So which particular protocol that's the part of that? Which using which particular protocol you can directly apply the email services? You can directly use the email services. So for that, the name of the protocol that is known as a SMTP. That is known as a simple mail transfer protocol. So with using this, you can directly sending the message to another computer users based on an email address. So this is the normal introduction about the SMTP. So up to this, at least you know the three important parameters. One, that is the email. For the email, which particular protocol? That is the SMTP. What is the full form of that? Simple mail transfer protocol. And then after, with using this, you can directly sending the message to another computer users based on a email address. After that, SMTP provides another functionality. With using the SMTP, you can directly provide the mail exchange between the different users on a same computer or a different computer. So already you know, if I want to send an email to another user, so with using the email functionality I can do that. So based on the email I can directly sending the message. So email supported by which protocol? So SMTP, that's the part of that. So with using the SMTP you can directly support the email functionality. So here you just see how many types of options with using the SMTP. First one, sending a single message to one or more receivers or recipients. Sending a message that include the text, voice, video or graphics. And third one, sending the message to users on a network outside the internet. So there are mainly different options. With using this you can directly send the message. With using this you can directly send the text. You can directly send the voice, video or graphics. After that, SMTP. SMTP protocol, the architecture of the SMTP protocol generally supported by the two compartment. One, that is the SMTP client, and second one, that is the SMTP server. So here you just see SMTP client is there, SMTP server is there, in between one internet is there, and different users are there. So again I repeat, if you talk about the architecture of the SMTP, so that is generally divided into two parts. One, that is known as a SMTP client. Second one, that is known as a SMTP server. So different users are there, in between internet are there. After that, SMTP architecture in a detail. So let's start with this. Again you just see what is the meaning of each and every parameter. That is the most important part here. So again, SMTP. So whenever you talk about the SMTP that supported the two compartment, that's the combination of SMTP client and SMTP server. After that, SMTP client and SMTP server again divided into two parts. One, that is known as a UA. Second one, that is known as a MTA. What is the full form of UA? UA means user agent. And what is the full form of MTA? Mail transfer agent. So one, that is UA, that is the user agent. Second one, that is the MTA, that is the mail transfer agent. What's the functionality of the user agent? So functionality of the user agent is that it prepares the message, creates the envelope, and puts the message in a envelope. So user agent supported the three functionality. First of all, preparing the message, creating an envelope, and puts the message in a envelope. After that, what is the functionality behind the MTA? MTA means mail transfer agent. So mail transfer agent directly transfer the mail across the internet. So again I repeat, SMTP architecture, whenever you talk about the SMTP architecture, that is generally divided into two parts. One that is known as a SMTP client, second one that is known as a SMTP server. After that, SMTP client and SMTP server again divided into two parts, user agent and mail transfer agent. What is the functionality behind the user agent? Preparing the message, creating the envelope, and puts the message in an envelope. And mail transfer agent transfer the mail across the internet. So that's all about the concept of the SMTP architecture. After that, here you just see again one diagram in a detailed manner. One user is there, one UA. UA means what? Because first diagram, all of you know, first diagram that totally belongs to user, SMTP client, internet, SMTP server, and user. But here I directly divide this particular diagram into another one. So user, then after UA. UA means what? User agent. MTA client means mail transfer agent client. Then after the internet, MTA server, user agent, and user B. So SMTP supported the two diagram. One diagram, user, SMTP client, internet, SMTP server, user. Second diagram, user, UA, MTA client, internet, MTA server, UA, and user B. So after that, here you just see, up to this, whatever the discussion that is related to the UA, that is related to the SMTP client, SMTP server, then after the talk about the MTA client. So here you just see, instead of just one MTA, means one mail transfer agent of the sender side and one at the receiving side, other MTAs acting either as a client or server and can relay the mail. So here you just see the figure. Now this figure, user agent, mail transfer agent, and then after, in between you put the different MTA, and at the receiving side the same diagram. So with using the different MTA, mail transfer agent, you can directly relay the mail to another host. So that's the logic for this. So again, up to this, then after SMTP, specific format for the email address, all of you know. For example, xyz@gmail.com, abc@yahoo.com. So what is the meaning of each and every compartment? So first compartment, that is related to the local part. Second compartment, that is related to the domain name. First one, local part, means that is the address of the mailbox on a local site, means XYZ, and domain name means the domain name of the destination, either that's from the Yahoo or from the Gmail or from the Hotmail. So that's the different compartment for this. So again, whenever you talk about the SMTP, you at least you know the syntax or format of the email address, generally divided into two. One, that is the local part. Second one, that is the domain name. So in local part, that is the XYZ, means that is the address, and domain name means the particular domain name of the destination. After that, what is the meaning of local part and what is the meaning of domain name? That's in a detail. So local part defines the name of a special file that is called the user mailbox, where all the mail received for a user is stored for retrieval by the message access agent. And domain name, the second part of the address, is the domain name. And organization usually select one or most host to receive and send the email. That already you know what is the meaning of local part and what is the meaning of domain name. After that, here you just see, domain name, the host are sometimes called the mail server or exchanger. Again, that is the technical word, must remember the name. The host are sometimes called the mail server or exchanger. Why? The domain name assigned to each mail exchanger either come from the DNS database or by a logical name. You can directly assign the different name to the each and every mail exchanger. So that's all about the concept of the SMTP. So must remember one thing. First of all, talk about the introduction of the SMTP. Then after the architecture of the SMTP. Then after the syntax of the email address. So each and everything that is the part of the SMTP. After that, next point for the today's session, that is the FTP. So why we use the FTP? That is the most important thing. What is the full form of FTP? So full form of FTP, that is the file transfer protocol. So file transfer protocol generally used for transferring the files on a network. So let's start with this. Here you just see what is the meaning of that. FTP, that is a one kind of standard mechanism that is generally provided by the TCP/IP for copying a file from one host to another. So transferring file from one computer to another computer, that's a one kind of common task in a networking or internetworking environment. So for that, if you want to transfer a file from one computer to another computer, so you can directly use the concept of the FTP. So the logic is that the system may use the different file name convention. Two systems may have the different way to represent the text and the data. Two systems may have different directory structure. So for this, the solution, that is the FTP. Means if you want to transfer a data with using this kind of techniques, so you can directly use the FTP. So whenever this kind of thing is there, so the different problem arise. So the solution of this particular problem, that is the use of the FTP. So you just see all of these problems have been solved by the FTP. So FTP differs from the client server application. The difference is that, what is the difference between FTP and client server application? The difference is that FTP and client server application difference is that it establishing the two connection between the host. Whenever you talk about the client server application, so client server application only establishing the connection between the, only apply the one connection between the client and server. But whenever you talk about the FTP, it establishing the two connection between the host. One connection that is generally used for the data transfer. Other connection that is generally used for the control information. What is the meaning of control information? So control information in terms of command and response. So again I repeat, if you talk about the connection for the FTP, so that supported the two connection, one connection for the data transfer and other connection for the control information, that is in a terms of the command and response. After that, then after the most important thing, separation of the command and separation of the data transfer makes the FTP more efficient. Why? Because here I establishing the two connection, one connection for the data transfer and one connection for the command. So which particular port number, that is the part of that. This is the last important topic in today's session. So here you just see the port number, that is the most important thing. The port 21, that is used for the control connection, and port 20, that is used for the data connection. So mainly two connection that is generally used for the FTP. Again, must remember the port number, that is the 21 that is used for the control, and port 20 that is used for the data. After that, this is the diagram for the FTP. That's very simple. User data and control data. After that, which kind of commands, that's the part of the FTP. So that is generally divided into six category. Means if you want to establishing the connection with communicate with the server, so there are mainly six types of command, six classes of commands, that's the part of the FTP. One, that is the access command. Second one, that is the file management command. third one, that is the data formatting command. Fourth one, that is the port defining command. Fifth one, that is the file transfer command. And sixth one, that is the miscellaneous command. So these all are the category of the command that is the part of the FTP. And the last point for the today's session, which kind of data transfer, which kind of file transfer, that's the part of the FTP. So file is copy from server to client, a file is copy from client to server, a list of directories or file name is sent from the server to client. So these type of file transfer, that can be the part of file transfer protocol. So that's the main point in a FTP. So in FTP, at least you know the port number, at least you know the two type of connection, one for the data transfer, one for the command or connection. So that's all about the today's session. In today's session, mainly two important topics. One, that is the SMTP, and second one, that is the FTP. So that's all about the today's session. Thank you for watching.